Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, giving you tips and tools to get organized and get prepared. So in this video, I'm going to show you my work from home office in a hallway. I've been working from home for 4 years and my son had moved back in to attend grad school. And when he moved in during COVID, I just spent the last few months trying to set up this space for my office. It used to be in that room through that door at the end of the hallway. And then I used to work in different areas of the home. I just need my laptop. But I decided to make this space for me and let it function for the different things that I need to get done throughout the day and the week. Okay, so I just walked from my master bedroom. They are double doors, so the lights are just there, so it could be brighter in this hallway. But the lighting is fine for the work that I need to do. And I love my palm tree here. And for decor, I just have this simple but beautiful world map that you scratch off. And I got it on Amazon. I'll put links to the items in this in my office in the description box below. So I just started. I have more places to scratch off, and I love it. It just shows me how much more of the world I need to explore. This space works because it's not just a skinny hallway, but it has this nook area. When my daughter was younger, this was her craft nook area, and then it became her reading corner, and now it's my home office, and it is on the second floor. So it has this open space that looks down into the living room and the entryway there. Over there to the right is my daughter's bedroom, and straight ahead used to be my son's room. Now he's in the guest room downstairs, and that is our workroom. He films his YouTube videos there. I'll put a link to his channel. That's also where I do get some work done, and I have my office supplies and prepper pantry in that closet. So basically, I made space where I had space, and I got her permission, and she said this is fine having it in this hallway. It's not too scrunched for her, so it works for us. Over here are four white bookshelves that I got from Walmart. They're about $25 each. They'll deliver to your door for free, so it's a great deal. This bookshelf is for stuff that I'm going to film for my YouTube videos. So if I have products here, then it's just a visual cue that I need to get that filmed. In this cubby, which I got from Target, they don't have this style anymore. There is a backpack, so I have to film my emergency go bag. So this was actually filled a little bit ago, but I filmed those videos. If you want to check out the iCards above, I did a fire escape kit and a home fire emergency go bag. And then over here, I have these Big Zo file boxes where I keep my everyday files there. This is for personal and this is for work. And I use the Freedom Filer system. I've been using this system, I think, for 4 or 5 years already. It completely works. And so it looks like this. And these are the monthly. You go even year or odd year. Since it's an even year, I have those there. And then the other boxes have the files for things that you need to save for taxes. And then these are inactive, so like the odd year is in there. When it becomes a new year, I'll switch those files to these, and then these will go there. So the color scheme, I've just kept kind of white and gold and some gray. So I got this at Ross years ago. It's a little piggy bank and reminds me of the rotary phone. A little bit of nostalgia there. And then I just have some books here that have the right color, which is white and gold. Good books, by the way. Okay, here I just have my gold scissors. These were Nate Burkus from Target a while back. Here is my Cal alumni cup. I graduated from Berkeley with a degree in economics, and I just have my stuff here for the world map. These are old Martha Stewart boxes and drawers and this whole system that she had at Staples. They might have an updated version, but I've just kept these. They are very sturdy. And yes, I do still write checks. This is ink for the printer. My printer is in the room to the left, so I don't need to have it here in the hallway or a shredder. The shredder is in my mail system that's downstairs. And then just some more boxes here and another set of cubbies. Okay, so I took everything down, and this is just kind of my working board. It really helps me to think. And I have my Cricut here. So this is kind of my craft space. And I've left the top here open just so I can lay things down. And then you can see over there, I left that open again. So there's just a little bit of a workspace there. Over here, I got this really cute tissue box. It's the shape of a house. And then my tape dispenser, stapler, again, all gold. There's some dry erase markers there. And then this is my laminating machine. I use this a lot. I've had this forever, the Staples brand. And then so these are actually empty, so I can still put stuff in there. And I have here the stuff for my Cricut machine. So example, vinyl or iron-on. Just thought it was nicer to put it vertically because they come in rolls like that. And then I just have here a trimmer and then some more stuff for my Cricut machine and a little space here where I can have projects or where I have some brand videos that I need to do, so I can keep those in those folders, so it just keeps it looking neater than just having paper outs on this tray. I put it in a folder. Oh, I almost forgot about this gold leaf. I got this at a thrift store and it's one of my favorite things and the system that I use with this. This is my outbox. So sometimes I eat up here, I have coffee or whatever, or I have like checks to mail or things to do. I put it on this tray. That is my visual cue that has to get out of this space. It completely works. It's, I think, a nice decorative element to this space. You could always have those, you know, trays, like an outbox tray, but this works for me. Okay, on the wall, I just have my diploma, this Be Wild and Wander, this little sign I made for YouTube, Simply Sherry, and then that is a wall calendar. I've been using this wall calendar instead of my daily planner. This has been so much better for me. Days have become like Blur's Day and, you know, it's still August, right? And so it's, you know, the months have just been blending into each other. So I've just had to have that out in the open because it just reminds me every day what day it is and what needs to get done. So that's a tip for you. You may be, for example, using a digital planner or a written calendar that you write on your desk, but you just need that system tweaked a little bit for the time being because it's maybe easier for you to remember things. So then put it on the wall or use post-it notes or something that is going to help you. You know, your office is here to support you, to get the things that you need to get done, not for you to support your office and however you set it up. So go ahead and tweak those systems, change it up a little bit, and see what's working for you. Okay, I just have these matching chairs and matching floor mats. This desk I got from IKEA. These drawers I got from Amazon because the IKEA version has been out of stock for a while. And then I just have this old fan and a small little mini fan there. I just need both during the summer months here. It gets really hot in Arizona, even with the AC. So I just need it to be cooler for myself. Got these two lamps, these gold ones from Target. And this ring light is necessary for the intros I do for my YouTube videos and for those Zoom calls. It's so much better having better lighting. And then these are my favorite pictures of my kids. And then I just have here for things that I need to access. I try not to fill this up too much. These have coasters for my water and usually my coffee, usually having two types of drinks. And this is my notebook to take notes specifically for YouTube. And then this is something that I need to laminate. And I have a wireless Rode mic that's on my phone right now. I usually keep it here. And yes, I have this little clock because for some reason, it's just easier for me to look at that sometimes than looking at the time on my laptop. This props up my phone. I just keep the plug there so that my phone is always juiced up. And then here I have a mouse pad. This is more ergonomic. This is a great mouse pad. It's really helped my wrist a lot. And then this is my laptop cover. Looks like I need to clean it. I think I was eating on this last night. Okay, so when I'm filming my intros, I usually move that over here so that the backdrop is the world map. But you can see that I've tried to leave this space open, especially this area, for if one of my kids wants to work here or if I need to work on something with my Cricut machine. Usually this space is taken up by food or notes that I need to take in my planner. And then over here I have a plant that's hanging on for dear life, still hanging on. And then this is a mirror that I ended up getting because before my Zoom calls, I'm like, what do I look like? And so I finally just got one to sit on the desk. I just have powder here and a brush. And then the nice thing is this one actually has a light. And then there's kind of like three-way, or it's just kind of, you know, a zoom on there. In the live video I did showing my office, I didn't show these drawers, so I'm going to show you now. I have a back scratcher here because my back is always itchy, and that's from the Dollar Tree. And right now I just have styrofoam because eventually I'm going to get some pieces of wood to prop this up because this wasn't the right size. It's not from IKEA, so it didn't support the IKEA desk, but it's working for me. So when I put those pieces of wood, I can still put something underneath there. And let's just go through the drawers. So up here, I just have these acrylic bins. They're drawer organizers. And I use museum putty underneath to keep them in place. So when you open and close the drawer, you see it doesn't move. Just have my gold ruler there. And yeah, these are all the pens that I use. Okay, this second drawer is basically all my yummies. So I just feel like all I do is eat around this desk. Yes, I need to have those snacks. These are new. I just wanted to have some lotion near here, and so that's there. I used to have the chocolate bar there, but now this fits. And then I have an extra mini fan back there. These acrylic inserts actually slide like that if you get the right size. So I just have my hair stuff there, some patches that I need to put. This is my makeup bag. Then I have some lipstick, chapstick here, and then my powder, and then this is my earbuds. Okay, down here I have some more same containers here, same museum putty. So this is kind of earphones, kind of electronic stuff or tech stuff. You got some stuff there in the back for, I think, cleaning my computer there, hard drive. Then you can just see some paper clips, binder clips, and staples and staple remover, glue stick. Okay, so here, empty bin. So just had that, see, like this, how it slides. So some stickers, post-it notes, some notes. Yeah, I use these a lot to take notes. And then a whole bunch of stickers for my planner, some stamps, and these. So this is my work from home office in the hallway. I hope you enjoyed this tour. If I'm replying to your comments, almost always I'm sitting there replying. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know where you have your home office or where you can put your home office after seeing this video. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.